It was a Friday night. Normally, I would have been out with friends at a bar somewhere, drinking myself into oblivion, but they were all out with family and I didn't feel like going by myself, so I was home alone. Having changed into my pajamas and a pair of warm socks, I padded down the hallway to the kitchen to get a drink and something to snack on before binge-watching my favorite show on Netflix. Grabbing a beer and a box of pseudo Ritz crackers. Hey, I'm a broke college student. I headed to the living room to flop down in my recliner and kick back to watch some TV. After locating my show and turning on the first episode, I took a long swallow of beer and opened the box of crackers. Grabbing one out, I stuffed it into my mouth and turned my attention to the show. I had probably worked my way through a third of the box before I needed another beer, and paused my show to go grab one. Returning to my recliner, I kicked back again and resumed the show, reaching for another cracker. I started to pop it into my mouth, but my attention was snagged by how unusual it looked. The cracker looked like a Pac-Man gone wrong, somehow. I mean, it had a mouth like he did, but inside that mouth was lined with rows of jagged teeth. Amused by its appearance, I stared at it for a while longer while laughing to myself, and then popped it into my mouth. A sharp pain erupted at the tip of my tongue before I could bite down, and immediately I fished the cracker back out. Eyeing it suspiciously, I looked for anything remotely sharp that could have caused that pain. Not seeing anything, I sighed and put it back into my mouth. This time the pain was intense, it felt like something was trying to saw my tongue in half. Emitting a garbled cry of pain, I went to retrieve the cracker. Only to find it was somehow attached to my tongue. Worried, I lunged out of the chair and raced to the bathroom, flipping on the light and going to the mirror over the sink. Opening my mouth wide, I peered in to meet a sight that made me suspect the Chinese I'd had for dinner had gone bad. That cracker was gnawing voraciously on my tongue. Blinking hard, I looked again. It was still gnawing on my tongue, and now it had drawn blood. Screaming, I tried to yank it off, but it wouldn't budge. I tried to snap it in half, but surprisingly the thing felt like a steel disc now, only with a mouth and teeth that was intent on eating my poor tongue. Tears blurring my vision, I continued to pull and yank and twist the possessed cracker to no avail. Finally, my eyes spied the flask of moonshine Jeff had left in there, and inspiration hit. Opening the flask, I poured a good mouthful and held it. That shit was 100 proof, if it didn't drown the fucking thing, by God it would get it drunk at least and maybe then it would let go of my fucking tongue so I could remove it. What felt like eternity went by before the gnawing stopped, but I didn't spit the moonshine out just yet. No, I waited another minute or two, wanting to make sure the fucker was dead or drunk before I opened my mouth again. When I felt like either option had surely happened, I spat the moonshine out in the sink and reached to tug the cracker loose. It wasn't dead. When I tugged it loose from my poor, abused tongue, it started snapping at the air drunkenly. I saw red. Screaming obscenities to the top of my lungs, I threw the cracker on the tile floor and used the steel flask to pound it into oblivion with. Goddamned motherfucking demon. Take that, you son of a bitch. Want to try to eat my goddamned tongue out again, fucker? Fuck you. Fuck you. When the cracker was nothing but a mushy paste of what looked like bread dough and blood, I wiped it up and flushed it down the toilet. Then I went into my bedroom, pulled on my work boots, and headed down the hall with a purpose. Reaching the living room, I picked up the box of crackers and took them into the kitchen, dumping them out on the tile. Grinning maniacally, I began stomping them into nothing. And that was the scene my roommates came home to, me in my PJs and work boots, looking like a crazed maniac, stomping half a box of crackers on the floor while muttering about demons eating my tongue off. "Hey, you all right there, dude?" Jeff asked, concerned. "Motherfucking crackers," I said, finished stomping them. "Goddamn possessed by demons. Don't ever buy these fake-ass Ritz crackers, man, they'll try to eat your fucking tongue off." "Okay then," Brian said, and pulled Jeff with him away from me down the hallway. I swept up the mess I'd made, and ran the cracker dust down the disposal with glee. Then I pulled off my work boots, walked back over to my recliner, and resumed watching my show. "Fuck eating goddamn crackers, I'd just stick to beer from here on out."